Hey everyone, me and Manaro here. I'm getting ready to watch the third episode to do my reaction to the it. It is daytime. I couldn't watch it last night because I got little ones and they wouldn't let me be great. So I'm gonna be watching it now and taping my reaction. So let me get started. I'm almost nervous. Watch this, I don't even know why. Oh, they made it to Castle Rock already. Ooh. Oh, John is here. I was about to say Castle Rock. That's John. They move quick.
This place has changed.
This is exciting.
I hear she's alive and well. She is. But she missed me terribly. A sham marriage. An unconsummated. I didn't ask where it was. It wasn't. Anyway. But smarter than she lets on. She's starting to let on. Good. At some point, I want to hear how a Night's Watch recruit became king of the North. As long as you tell me how a Lannister became hand to Daenerys Targaryen.
First dragon.
I'd say you get used to them. Never really do.
See that look on his face?
Come. The mother's waiting for you.
I'm gonna need you to stay alive.
I wondered why you weren't there to meet our guests. You begged us to summon the king in the north. Don't you want to see him again?
I've done my part. I've brought ice and fire together.
Strange. You spoke so highly of Snow, but when he arrives, you hide on a cliff. I didn't take you for a bashful girl.
My time whispering in the ears of kings has come to an end.
Oh, I doubt that. Give us common folk one taste of power. We're like the lion who tasted man. Nothing is ever so sweet again.
Neither of us is common folk anymore. I did not part on good terms with the king of the north. His advisor.
Why?
Because of mistakes I made. Terrible mistakes. I would only be a distraction if I stayed.
So where will you go?
Volantis.
Good. If you don't mind my saying, I don't think you should return to Westeros. I'm not sure you'll be safe here.
Is that a threat?
I will return, dear Spider. One last time.
My lady.
I have to die in this strange country. Just like you.
Ooh. 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 Did she see that in her flames? Ooh, Varys don't like that.
...of Daenerys Stormborn of House Targaryen, rightful heir to the Iron Throne. Rightful queen of the Andals and the First Men, protector of the Seven Kingdoms, the mother of dragons, the Khaleesi of the Great Grass Sea, the Unburnt,
titles,
the Breaker
titles,
of Chains.
Titles.
This is Jon Snow. He's king in the north.
Thank you for traveling so far, my lord. I hope the seas weren't too rough.
The winds were kind, your grace. Apologies. I have a flea-bottom accent, I know. But Jon Snow is king in the north, your grace. He's not a lord.
Forgive me.
Your grace, this is Sir Davos Seaworth.
Forgive me, Sir Davos. I never did receive a formal education. But I could have sworn I read the last king in the north was Torrhen Stark, who bent the knee to my ancestor, Aegon Targaryen. exchange for his life and the lives of the Northmen, Torrhen Stark swore fealty to House Targaryen in perpetuity. Or do I have my facts wrong?
I wasn't there, Your Grace.
No, of course not. But still, an oath is an oath. And perpetuity means... What does perpetuity mean, Lord Tyrion?
Forever.
Forever. So I assume, my lord, you're here to bend the knee.
I am not.
No. Well, that is unfortunate. You've traveled all this way to break faith with House Targaryen?
Break faith? Your father burned my grandfather alive. He burned my uncle alive. He would have burned the Seven Kingdoms.
My father was an evil man. On behalf of House Targaryen, I ask your forgiveness for the crimes he committed against your family. And I ask you not to judge a daughter by the sins of her father. Our two houses were allies for centuries. And those were the best centuries the Seven Kingdoms have ever known. Centuries of peace and prosperity. With a Targaryen sitting on the Iron Throne and a Stark serving as Warden of the North. I am the last Targaryen, Jon Snow. Honor the pledge your ancestor made to mine. Bend the knee and I will name you Warden of the North. Together, we will save this country from those who would destroy it.
Not guilty of your father's crimes, and I'm not beholden to my ancestors' vows.
Then why are you here?
Because I need your help, and you need mine.
Did you see three dragons flying overhead when you arrived?
I did.
And did you see the Dothraki? All of whom have sworn to kill for me.
They're hard to miss.
But still, I need your help.
Not to defeat Cersei. You could storm King's Landing tomorrow and the city would fall. Hell, we almost took it and we didn't even have dragons. Almost. But you haven't stormed King's Landing. Why not? The only reason I can see is you don't want to kill thousands of innocent people. It's the fastest way to win the war, but you won't do it. Which means, at the very least, you're better than Cersei.
Still, that doesn't explain why I need your help.
Because right now, you and I and Cersei and everyone else, we're children playing at a game screaming that the rules aren't fair.
You told me you liked this man.
I do.
In the time since he's met me, he's refused to call me queen, he's refused to bow, and now he's calling me a child.
I believe he's calling all of us children.
I was born at Dragonstone. Not that I can remember it. We fled before Robert's assassins could find us. Robert was your father's best friend, no? I wonder if your father knew his best friend sent assassins to murder a baby girl in her crib. Not that it matters now, of course. I spent my life in foreign lands. So many men have tried to kill me. I don't remember all their names. I have been sold like a brood mare. I've been shamed. And betrayed, raped, and defiled. Do you know what kept me standing through all those years in exile? Faith. Not in any gods. Not in myths and legends. In myself. In Daenerys Targaryen. The world hadn't seen a dragon in centuries until my children. The Dothraki hadn't crossed the sea. Any sea. They did for me. I was born to rule the Seven Kingdoms. And I will.
You'll be rolling over a graveyard. If we don't defeat the Night King. The war against my sister has already begun. You can't expect us to halt hostilities and join you in fighting. You saw beyond the wall. destiny has brought Daenerys Targaryen back to where she was. It has also made Jon Snow king in the north. You were the first to bring Dothraki to Westeros. He is the first to make allies of wildlings and northmen. He was named Lord Commander of the Night's Watch. He was named king in the north. Not because of his birthright. He has no birthright. He's a damn bastard. All those hard sons of bitches chose him as their leader because they believe in him. All those things you don't believe in. He faced those things. He fought those things for the good of his people. He risked his life for his people. He took a knife in the heart for his people. He gave his own... If we don't put aside our enmities and band together, we will die. And then it doesn't matter whose skeleton sits on the Iron Throne.
If it doesn't matter, then you might as well kneel. Swear your allegiance to the Queen Daenerys. Help her to defeat my sister, and together our armies will protect the North.
There's no time for that. There's no time for any of this. While we stand here debating, takes...
This scene kind of fell flat for me.
Our Ironborn and Dornish allies were attacked en route to Dorne.
And?
Two or three ships escaped. The rest sunk or captured. Ilaria and the Sand Snakes dead or captured. The Greyjoys dead or captured.
All of them.
They know. They know. They know. Roll in like Tywin.
Justice for your murdered daughter.
You've proven yourself the greatest captain on the 14 seas, and a true friend to the crown.
You deserve more than a true friend.
And you deserve a proper reward for your heroism.
There's only one reward I want.
You shall have what your heart desires.
Battered my sister not long ago.
such skill with a spear. Even Sir Gregor couldn't stop him. If only he hadn't taunted him. He could have walked away and left poor Sir Gregor to die. But that wasn't your lover's way, was it? Now he's buried somewhere. And here's Sir Gregor stronger than ever. That must be difficult for you. When my daughter was taken from me, my only daughter. Well, you can't imagine how that feels unless you've lost a child. I fed her at my own breast, even though they told me to give her to the wet nurse. I couldn't bear to see her in another woman's arms. I never got to have a mother. But Marcella did. She was mine. And you took her from me. Why did you do that? I stare at the canopy and imagine ways of killing my enemies. How to destroy Ilaria Sand, the woman who murdered my only daughter. I thought about having Sir Gregor crush your skull the way he did Oberyn's. Would be poetic, I suppose, but fast, too fast. I thought about having him crush your daughter's skull. She's so beautiful. The thought of this lovely face cracking open like a duck egg.
Nice.
Your daughter will die here in this cell. And you will be here watching what she does. You'll be here the rest of your days. If you refuse to eat the false food down your throat, you will live to watch your daughter rot.
Nice.
To watch that beautiful face collapse to bone. All the while contemplating the choices you've made.
Nice.
Make sure the guards change the torches every few hours. I don't want her to miss a thing.
Oh, nice. She always gets amorous after killing someone, like the Mad King.
It's hard for me to fathom, it really is. If someone told me about the White Walkers and the Night King...
You sound like ridiculous.
She's not about to head north to fight an enemy she's never seen on the word of a man she doesn't know. After a single meeting, it's not a reasonable thing to ask. Do you
you have anything reasonable to ask?
What do you mean?
Maybe you are a Northern fool. I'm asking if there's something I can do to help you.
Dragon glass.
Yes, volcanic glass. Obsidian. He says you have a tremendous amount of it here.
Why are we talking about glass? We just lost two of our allies.
Which is why I was speaking to Jon Snow. Ally.
What does the king in the north want with dragon glass?
Apparently it can be turned into weapons that kill white walkers and their foot soldiers. Or stop them. Destroy them. Unsure about the nomenclature. Let him mine the dragon glass. If he's wrong, it's worthless. You didn't even know it was here. It's nothing to you. Give him something.
How much do we have?
4,000 bushels, my lady.
What does that mean?
For the current occupants of the castle, it's enough food for a year. Perhaps more.
What's the longest winter in the past 100 years?
I'm not entirely certain. I'll check Mesa Lewin's records. He kept a copy of every Raven scroll.
You're telling me we don't have enough food? Especially not if the armies of the north come back to defend Winterfell.
No. My lady, most likely not.
We must prepare for that eventuality. Whatever direction the threat comes from, this is the best place to be. We need to start building up our grain stores with regular shipments from every keep in the north. If we don't use it by winter's end, we'll give it back to them. But if the entire north has to flee to Winterfell, they won't have enough time to bring wagon loads of grain with them.
Very wise, my lady.
Mr. Wall, can you see to it? Covering those breastplates in leather?
No, my lady.
Shouldn't they be? That's the real cold cunt.
They should indeed. Pardon me, my lady. You there. What's in their leather, please?
Command suits you. The northerners are all facing north, worried about the threat from beyond the wall.
So they should be.
I know Cersei better than anyone here. If you turn your back on her.
You don't know Cersei better than anyone here.
I only meant to say
that the woman who murdered my mother, father, and brother is dangerous. Thank you for your wise counsel.
One of two things will happen. Either the dead will defeat the living, in which case all our troubles come to an end, or life will win out. What then? Don't frighten the north or the south. Every battle, everywhere, always, in your mind. Everyone is your enemy. Everyone is your friend. Every possible series of events is happening all at once.
He is so cool.
But that way, nothing will surprise you. Everything that happens will be something that you've seen before.
Lady Sansa, at the gate.
Is it Arya? Tell me it's Arya. Please tell me it's Arya. Run! Run!
Hello, Sansa.
Run.
I wish John were here.
Yes. I need to speak to him.
Your father's last living treeborn son. You're Lord of Winterfell now.
I can never be Lord of Winterfell. I can never be Lord of anything. I'm the Three-Eyed Raven.
I don't know what that means.
It's difficult to explain.
Try, please, for me.
Just looks like now. And you were so beautiful. In your white wedding dress.
I have to go back inside, Brad.
Ooh. He's healing. CT. He touched him first.
No one has ever taken the Rock. The Lannister army is still the army my father built. Well-trained and well-provisioned. 10,000 men at least. They will see us coming. They will be ready.
I should have just took your dragons.
Better place for low pursuits than beneath the ground. Casterly Rock is an impregnable fortress. But as a good friend of mine once said, give me 10 good men and I'll impregnate the bitch.
Nice.
And so it begins. Face the bulk of the Lannister forces. They will be outnumbered. They will have less armor and fewer weapons. But my sister's armies fight for her out of fear. The Unsullied will be fighting for something greater. They will be fighting for freedom and the person who gave it to them. They will be fighting for you. That is why they will triumph.
He doesn't die today.
Dorian lost.
Here comes Euron. Rattles.
Where are they? Where are the rest of the Lannisters?
Run! Oh yeah, he about to bite it. Rains of Castamere. Nice.
Defending Casterly Rock.
The truth is, Casterly Rock isn't worth much anymore.
Well, it is to me. My fond childhood memories won't keep Cersei on the throne.
So you just let them take it?
For now, they won't be able to hold it. Euron Greyjoy's navy burned their ships. We emptied the larders before we left. Eventually, they'll be forced to abandon their position and march all the way across Westeros.
And you took your army, your real army, went where they weren't.
As Robb Stark did to me at Whispering Wood. There are always lessons and failures.
Yes. You must be very wise by now.
My father always said I was a slow learner.
If he was so clever, why didn't he take Highgarden the moment your gold mines ran dry? I suppose I'll be able to ask him myself soon enough. No more learning from my mistakes. How will you do it? With that sword? That was Joffrey's sword, wasn't it? Not that he ever used it. What did he call it? watch them being done on my orders. I never lost a night's sleep over them. They were necessary. And whatever I imagined necessary for the safety of House Tyrell, I did. But your sister has done things I was incapable of imagining. That was my prize mistake. She's a monster, you do know that.
To you, I'm sure. To others as well. But after we've won, there's no one left to oppose us. When people are living peacefully in the world she built, do you really think they'll wring their hands over the way she built it?
You love her. You really do love her. You poor fool. She'll be the end of you.
Possibly. To be gained from discussing it with you, though, is there?
What better person to discuss it with? What better guarantee could you have that the things you say will never leave this room? But perhaps you're right. If she's driven you this far, it's gone beyond your control.
Yes. It has.
She's a disease. I regret my role in spreading it.
I think we're done here.
How will it happen?
Cersei had several ideas. Whipping you through the streets and beheading you in front of the Red Keep. Flaying you alive and hanging you from the walls of King's Landing. I talked her out of those.
Poison.
I'd hate to die like your son, clawing at my neck, foam and bile spilling from my mouth, eyes blood red, skin purple. Must have been horrible to you, as a king's guard, as a father. It was horrible enough for me. A shocking scene. Not at all what I intended.
No.
You see, I'd never seen the poison work before. Tell Cersei. I wanted to know it was me.
Nice. Trolled one last time. Olenna went out like a G. Okay. This one. Okay, I don't know what to. Okay, so let me start with Daenerys and Jon. That meeting fell flat for me. I don't know, I guess I was expecting more, but it served its purpose. We got them together. I'm glad that Jon stood his ground and didn't bend his knee to her. And it's good to see, now we're seeing how the pieces are moving. Usually in most stories, the bad guy always usually has the upper hand, and then the good guys usually come around. I have to admit that Cersei is doing well, like things are moving well in Cersei's way. So, and I really like the way that she's doing Ilaria and Tyene. That was sadistic. That was really good. So I have to give it to Cersei. Cersei is is making all the right moves right now. And she is outsmarting Tyrion. But they still have some aces in the hole, so I guess we'll see what happens next episode. Bran is back home, but he just seems like really out of touch, like he's losing like his human side, if that makes any sense. I'm glad that him and Sansa got to see each other and that he's home in Winterfell. Let's see. Euron is a freaking troll. I have to say, I really liked him in this episode. He was a freaking troll. I'm not even going to talk about Jaime and Cersei because whatever. Let's see. That little conversation between Melisandre and Viserys, and Varys, I really enjoyed that exchange. That was really good. Did she see something in her flames? She knows she's going to bite it. And she told him he's going to die too. So, let's see how that plays out. And I guess the last thing that I'll talk about is them taking Highgarden. So I guess Tarly went over to the Lannister side. So I guess he will now get Highgarden and become the Warden of the South. Or is it Warden of the East? No, Warden of the West. No, Warden of the South. It'll be Warden of the South. And I like the way that Olenna... I love the way that Olenna trolled Jaime one last time. That was good. And she went out like a G. Oh, that's awesome. So most of the major players are being removed from the board so that we can have the key players. Jorah is now cured and is going to be heading his way back to Daenerys. Jon and Davos made it fairly quickly, so, and without meeting up with anybody. I would have liked to see them at least see parts of their travel, or at least been able to see White Harbor, because we don't have that many episodes. They got to just move things along a lot faster, so I guess. So, overall, this episode was okay. I didn't, you know, like I said, the meeting between John and Danny kind of fell flat for me. I don't know if it was because of the dialogue or what it was. It didn't have the wow factor that I was expecting it to have. But overall, I guess it served its purpose for whatever story they're trying to tell. It served its purpose. That's it. I really don't have much else to say. It wasn't as exciting as I thought it was going to be. I guess I can't find the words. It just didn't, whatevers. So thanks again for spending some time with me and watching, and I'll end it here. Peace.